is a person who is willing to suffer if necessary for the cause and the welfare of the Namibian people.
Sound is there.
He's patient even when he's under pressure.
It's fine now, the sound is there.
He's also willing to share his accomplishments with all of us. Some people, when they accomplish something, it's mine. Dr. Gangob is willing to share. And there's ministers and other people whom he has appointed to several beautiful positions can testify to that. He's a teacher by choice and by profession. He is a SWAPO party activist by excellence. His record as a civil servant, as an international civil servant, is there for everybody to see. He was the one who taught us the word director. Director of United Nations Institute for Namibia. Ask the good lawyer, Albert Kawana, a doctor in law. He's a product of that institution. Who else is here? One of the advisors, Inge Kami Damani. Damani Kami. So there, he has a record of accomplishment, and his product also have records of accomplishment. He was our director of the first election we ever had in the Republic of Namibia, way back in 1989. He taught us what it means to go and vote. He taught us what it means to organize an election. Everybody will tell you, I am telling you my rights from the Namibian constitution, the most beautiful constitution in the world. They don't even know who was there sweating it out with other people, including members of opposition parties, to craft that constitution. It was Dr. Gainga who was the chair of that meeting. It was he who was the chair of the drafting committee. It was he who ensured that the constitution was unanimously adopted by all members. And therefore, there was no other doubt that he would emerge as the prime minister, the first prime minister of the Republic of Namibia. And later, it was also not surprising that he became the president of the Republic of Namibia, and later, the president of the ruling party. The third person in all those two positions I have mentioned. He's a good listener. He's a good speaker. You should listen also to him. As I said before, he's a very fair person, sometimes too fair. But the competition is always, who are the best friends of Hage Gangob? And even two people who are fighting one another, they are still claiming that they are good friends of Hage Gangob. That is not the way to be a good friend. If you are a good friend of Hage Gangob, also be a friend to another person who is also a good friend of Hage Gangob. And that is what we should be today. He's a friend of all, he's a leader of us all, and therefore he deserves that we listen to him. May I therefore ask you all to rise and receive him at the podium. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Director of this event. The governor of this great region, the mayor, the traditional authorities, they are always around, all of them, whenever we come here. as a one region, they all come and join us. So I'd like to thank them for their presence. Bishop, you just started the day for me. Your prayer was. This kind of a prayer, we cannot go wrong in our deliberation of today. I'm not referring to anything else. Don't conclude now. I'm not referring to yesterday, it was a good meeting. But thank you very much for that prayer. I'm not alone, because this year was declared year of accountability. Now, I went back to be a phrase which says transparency plus accountability spells trust. Mathematically, T plus A equals TR. So we declare this year as a year of accountability. To who? To the sovereigns, the people of this country, who trusted us, gave us power to, on their behalf, administer the country. People are the final sovereigns. They are the bosses. Now, in the past, in the Greek city state, all citizens used to come and co-administer. Because the populations were smaller, they would all come and join the administration. But as populations became bigger, they had to get what they call representative government. Government elected to vote and represent the citizens. On their behalf, they send you and say, I give you 5 years in our case. Based on your manifesto, I vote into your provinces. So go for 5 years, represent me. I'll watch you whether you're carrying out what you promised. And then I have the power to decide whether I would like you to go on or not. That's what we call social contract with the people, the sovereign. So therefore, this is the year to account. We are here because of that. But I'm not alone. I cannot account alone. We have people, the vice president, the prime minister, the whole cabinet, because there are about 14 here, some members of parliament. So what I'm going to say, I'm not going to speak alone. We are all going to account. And I thank the ministers, really. I was sorry for some of them. I am surprised to see them here. They drove apparently during the night. Who told you to drive during the night? So give them really a big hand. They drove at this hour. I was fortunate to be given a lift by the plane to bring me here. Comrade Sarah had a plane, so she gave me a lift. So we didn't suffer. But Vice President was driving. He got up this morning, 5 o'clock, the car, the road, 6 o'clock. Plane, we say, wheels up. The wheels run, in his case, on the road. 6 o'clock, and he came here. That's commitment. Oh, market. Next time I come, I have to be careful of this market. I must, wherever I go, I must adopt the custom. So I am not alone. I would like the Vice President, of course, and Chairman, you are also equally recognized. Thank you. I'm in your audience. Omage. Vice President, get up and be seen now in your capacity. Not the man.
Not the man who is introducing the other one. Prime Minister, the ministers must get up first and face the people so they can see your faces. Some of you are not known, maybe. The deputy ministers, can you join? The executive directors, formerly known as permanent secretaries. The advisors. The parliamentarians. Now this is your government. The whole government is here, the cabinet is here. And we are here to account. But in accounting, we are also going to learn through your questions. You'll give us also tasks to go and carry out, and then account later on when campaign starts. So please, ministers, you may be seated. My speech is going to be delivered by all of us. You see, we, the current leaders, I'm the number three, you said? I'm number three in the government, number three in the party. Trinity, be careful. So, I will be talking through all these people who are here. I'll be answering your questions through them. But not one individual is so clever. We are here, therefore, to account collectively. So, talking about our governance architecture, we are a fully fledged democracy, no question about it. We have regular, free, and fair elections. If there is a problem, people have a right to go to the institutions. So, we, the third wave of presidents, because the first wave of presidents were extraordinary personalities who told us, wake up, you are oppressed. Stand up and fight for your rights, your freedoms. Those are the founding fathers of African independent countries. Kwame Nkrumah, Sekou Toure, Keita, Nasa, Nyerere, Kaunda. That's the first wave of African leaders. When you can fast track, although the times differ, when you come now to our part, you get now President Mugabe, Zimbabwe, President Nyoma, Namibia, President Mandela, South Africa. Although they are a little bit 30 years after the others, they are in the same category as those first wave leaders who were extraordinary personalities, the founding members, part group of leaders. Second wave leaders came during the terrible time of Cold War competition. Cold War, East-West competition. We're caught up in that, followed by military coups, one-party states, and so on. Third wave is now, I'm third. Third wave are those who are not big guys. I'm not going to physically look, I'm very big. I'm not saying Nyoma, the founding father, or Mandela, Cyril Mandela. We are different type. So therefore, not being extraordinary personalities, we are people for processes, systems, and institutions. Therefore, processes, governance, processes, systems, institutions. The courts are independent. Those are institutions. Governance, architecture, with processes, whether it's electoral process, whether it is governance, systems, it's there. So when I said in the beginning, when your business plans don't come to me with them, go through the processes, systems. Ministers, line ministers. So equally, I'm here with ministers also because I don't have all the answers to your questions you may ask. And my speech is going to be delivered through all of us. I have now started to talk about to ground our presence here. Then I will be calling on somebody, advisor, to then try to account when we're here, as you referred, on the 6th of August, 2015, I think. So she will now just bring us back because we are here to account. Thereafter, the Prime Minister will take the floor to talk about the drought, which is affecting the whole country. Thereafter, we will then allow the local authorities here to take over and then bring in you who are here to either ask questions, not make too long a speech, because some of you are staffed, a crowd like this. So when you see that opportunity, you want to make a long speech. It's not your day. You are here to ask questions, not speeches, to elaborate on things, but politicians, please, also of the parties. Yesterday we had political campaign there. So ask questions. We are here to hold hands. We are not enemies. Namibia is the only country we can say it's our home. All of us. So inclusivity spells harmony. Let's be inclusive, let's hold hands to pull in the same direction. This is the only country we have. Maintain the peace we have. Let's disagree over being disagreeable. Let's disagree. Pastor, Bishop told us that. And wherever we went, pastors are telling us in the beginning what to do, but we go and do wrong things. They've been preaching now for how many years? Love your neighbor, just like you. But we still hate our neighbor. But in Namibia, let's hold hands now. It's the only country we have. Countries which went to war, you are watching on TV what happens. Small children suffering. No peace. To sit like this, to talk, to disagree. So inclusivity spells harmony. Exclusivity. Conflict. Where you have that, Libya is a peaceful country under Gaddafi. Now let's face it, the truth. Things were happening. Americans came to bring democracy. What happens? Now people are suffering. Name all these countries where there is conflict. You cannot sit like this and talk about your future, about drought and things we are facing, poverty and so on. So therefore, I want to say again that our churches, our traditional leaders, professionals, medical doctors, parliamentarians, this is the only country we can call on. Our people, uniform people, I was reminded I'm a commander-in-chief. Sometimes we forget we are newcomers. But I'm a commander-in-chief. I see my people sitting there. It's so nice to sit like this. In the house, Namibian house, that we are building. It's nice. Namibian house composed of different ethnic groups, races. But to sit in this house, it's not beautiful. So why do you want to cause trouble? Let's just agree to see we have problems. Let's advise each other so that we can solve our problems. and live together in this Namibian house as brothers and sisters and pull in the same direction so that one day we can achieve our goal, that of dealing with poverty, backwardness, that our people can have decent living conditions. Inequality is growing, poverty is growing, drought is here. It's for us to seize the opportunity to see what can we do to maintain peace in our beloved Namibia. What can we do to share those who have something but those who don't have? I see the Vice Chancellor also. Welcome. If there are other scholars, welcome. Other leaders of political parties, welcome. Already I'm proving we are in the Namibian house. We can have different views. We can disagree in parliament. But you know this is the only place you can call your home. No other place. So, thank you very much. I will now call on, I'm still speaking, Inge to come and continue my speech. Thank you.
Thank you, Your Excellency. Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
On 5th of August 2015, the Zambezi Town Hall Meeting took place. It was a continuous engagement of 7 hours. Various representatives of stakeholders, such as the youth, traditional authorities, women, elders, business community, farmers, the churches, the disabled, the marginalized, and the local authorities posed questions. It was an interesting dialogue. Out of the questions posed and proposals made, 11 action letters were generated. These letters were then sent to the line ministries. They were requested to look at those issues and proposals made and make them part of their implementation plans to address those issues. These issues also formed the basis of the Harambee Prosperity Plan. And over the years, through the regional state of the address and the state of the nation address, feedback has been given countrywide on those issues. But today, in line with a year of accountability, His Excellency is here to give feedback specifically to the residents of the Zambezi region. To kickstart off the feedback, the first category to raise issues was the youth. They raised 6 issues. Number one, they were concerned that rural school electrification remained low. And the feedback that we have is that, of course, rural electrification remains one of our challenges. The pace of implementation is slow, owing to a number of factors, including the economic downturn, as well as cost of supply materials. However, that notwithstanding, government has managed to electrify 6 rural schools since 2015. The second concern from the youth or request that was that more primary school hostels and youth hostels be constructed, because many young children, in the absence of hostels, were forced to travel long distances. The feedback to give is that indeed, this is one of the areas that government is looking at, construction of new hostels or renovation of existing hostels. However, in the meantime, two school hostels, the construction of two school hostels have commenced, namely the one at Doro Memorial School. This hostel is currently estimated to be at 67% execution rate. And the second is the hostel at Luhonono, which have just started at about 25%. With respect to sports facilities, the concern raised by the youth was that there were no floodlights at the sports fields. The feedback we have is that since then, floodlights have been installed at Katima Mulilo Sports Complex. The fourth concern raised by the youth was that water and electricity at the sports facilities were made available only when national leaders were in attendance. Actually, the feedback is that if you go to the sports stadium and the electricity is off, it's due to non-payment. It's not because there is no national leader in town. But we can report that the electricity has since been reconnected at the sports facility. If this is not the case, I'm sure we can, during the dialogue session, deliberate on it. Number five was that the youth were not benefiting from the multi-purpose youth center. We look into this, and the feedback is actually there were a number of youth out of school, youth and unemployed youth who were provided with training. A number of 171 out of school unemployed youth were provided with training in end-use computer skills. And 88 have been trained in tailoring at that particular multi-purpose center. Number six.
From the youth was the fact that there was no hostel or higher vocational training center in the Zambezi region. The feedback is that indeed, while there is no hostel in the region, the Zambezi Vocational Training Center is here, where I think is very well known to many of the residents of Zambezi region, and it is one of the two VCTs that has a fully operational production unit. Now, a production unit is like a business owned by the Vocational Training Center, where the trainees go out and provide services, be it whatever the skills that they are learning, and they charge a fee for it. They go to schools, they repair broken chairs, they fix windows, they fix all our other things for a fee, and therefore they are learning and they have to run businesses while also applying their practical skills. Furthermore, at the Zambezi Vocational Training Center, two new occupational subjects were introduced into the curriculum, namely farming equipment and infrastructure, in horticulture and crop production. This brought the total number of subjects offered in the VCT to 9. To date, there are about 654 trainees enrolled at this VCT, of which 270 are likely to graduate this year. So that's the feedback on the issues raised by the youth. The second stakeholder group to speak was the women, and they raised a number of issues. One, there was perception that teachers' compensation is insufficient. The feedback is that, of course, in 2016, government and the Namibia National Teachers Union reached an agreement on salary increment of 9% for all the teachers countrywide. And since then, there has been, as part of the public service negotiations with the government, there has been a number of negotiations, some of which are still ongoing, to improve the conditions of service and remuneration of civil servants. But I think we are all aware that we are facing challenges and that the needs are many, and therefore we should also allow our government to stretch the limited resources far, especially to meet the needs of the most vulnerable. Number two from the women was a concern that houses constructed under the mass housing program were too expensive, and therefore women were asking for land so that they can service the land, but unfortunately due to limited resources they couldn't do that. The feedback is that since the conversation in 2015, 203 low-cost houses that were constructed under the mass housing development program in this region have been allocated and occupied between 2015 to this year. And that in fact, some of the houses, the price ranges from 200,000 to 500,000. Furthermore, the council, town council of Patino Mreno, has entered into 6 public-private sector partnerships to construct more low-cost houses, of which 103 out of the 187 houses have been completed, and of those that have been completed, 63 are already occupied. The third issue to be raised by the mothers, two separate but related issues pertain to the health sector. Number one, that the lack of doctors and nurses and the hospital and the referral of patients to far distance places were resulting in patients dying in transit, especially in route to the Rundu referral or Katutura referral hospital in Bendu. The second was the long queues that are experienced at state health facilities. The feedback is that with regard to the number and the capacity of healthcare facilities, 3 new clinics in the region have been constructed and inaugurated, namely the Lusese, Goma in Kayanga clinics, either constructed or renovated or upgraded from a clinic to a health center. In addition, the ministry, the Lion Ministry of Health and Social Services, in consultation with the partners, are visiting, and a groundbreaking took place already to construct the Katima Molino maternal shelter. With respect to the doctors, the shortage of doctors, the ministry has also put in place mobile outreach clinics to various places to take the health services to the people. And to this end, these outreach services have been to Sibinda, Sangoni, and Bukalo. Furthermore, additional Cuban specialists have been recruited through the Namibia-Cuban partnership, which resulted in the recruitment of a number of specialists, one surgeon, one obstetrician, one pediatrician, and one pharmacist and a dentist. We are informed that as a result of this new recruitment, the referrals have reduced by as much as 70%. And that only one day has occurred since then during transit to a referral hospital. And that happened last year, which is regrettable, but there has been noticeable improvement. In addition, Katima Mulilo has now a private dialysis center, which was opened recently. In addition, the region has also benefited from the doctor's outreach program, where specialist doctors come to the regions for a week or more to perform those complicated medical procedures. The next issue that was raised by the mothers was a concern that health inspectors around Katima Molino were not paying attention to the health hazard around informal settlements such as Choto, Cowboy, and Maonona, especially these hazards resulting from dust produced by gravel roads in and around these informal settlements. These are informal settlements, and therefore services have not been fully rolled out to these areas, and we therefore recognize the challenge. However, the planning for proper reception centers and upgrading of the informal settlement will assist with the provisions of services over time. And therefore, we hope that residents of Katima Molino will cooperate with the town council as they try to bring planning to those areas so that services can be brought in. With regards to the sewage system, the town council is busy cleaning the lines and rerouting some of the pipes to alleviate the current pressure on the sewer line. Moving on to the third category of stakeholders that pose questions or make proposals was the marginalized representative of the marginalized communities. And there was perception that government is not doing enough to protect workers' rights, and that workers were subjected to beatings and other forms of demeaning practices. Of course, the feedback remains that there are established structures through which these type of complaints can be taken, and the incidences of malpractices and violation of workers' rights can be reported. We have labor inspectors, we have the labor ministry's regional office, after which if the local structures fail, these matters can be referred to the line ministries or the labor commission in Benue. And of course we acknowledge that our marginalized communities may not have access and means to reach to an established structure to report such cases. And therefore, the responsibility is on their local leaders and traditional authorities to help them take those concerns and complaints through the relevant structures. The fourth group to rise and pose questions were the elders, the senior citizens. They had three concerns. One, that locally produced Kalimbesa rice was too expensive. All know that this region has established a brand called Kalimbesa rice. And of course, a package of 1 kg is priced at $11.50, but compared to other brands on the market, like Tasty Rice or Mama, or we consider that the Kalimbesa rice price is still fairly reasonable. And the reason why the rice produced locally is expensive is because also the input costs are high. So the producers need to be able to meet, at least from the selling price, their input costs. So water, electricity, fertilizers and labors are not cheap. And this may contribute towards the perception that the price of $11.50 is high, and it means that the community understands that pricing is informed by a number of factors. The second issue that was tabled was concerned that there was poaching of rhinos by a Zambian syndicate. We went and made investigations, and what we have been informed is in fact that there were more cases of elephant poaching as opposed to rhinos. A total number of 19 elephants were poached between 2017 and this year. And from those cases, a total number of 71 suspects were arrested. So we are aware that this region has a serious problem of poaching, and therefore the ministry, the line ministry, and the law enforcement agencies are working together, and we have put in place a number of strategies to address the issues of poaching, such as the anti-poaching patrols by the Ministry of Environment and Tourism. And sometimes these patrols are strengthened by the presence of NAMPOL and NDF, especially in key problematic areas. They are also using intelligence gathering and investigations, and it's up to us as citizens and residents to report cases that we are aware of, where our neighbors or our own relatives might be involved in poaching activities to the law enforcement agencies. That will help to reduce the issue of poaching. The The third point raised by the senior citizens was that there was a serious problem existing in the Western Zambezi region with respect to cellular network and television signals and the coverage in the Western Zambezi region was very poor for both television and cellular network. You can report from information we have received from the Land Ministry that to date 82.3% of the population is covered by MTC and telephone network infrastructures. And that since 2015, six MTC towers were commissioned and Mafuta, Ibu, Barasinde, Itomba, Sikazebuka, and Sikalume areas. Furthermore, the MTC coverage from information received from the ministry is that it is now covered by digital terrestrial television transmitters as opposed to analog, which is still available in other regions, as we have learned. And so to date, at least 54% of the inhabitants are currently covered by the DGT transmitters. Then, this particular concern, whether it came from the governor's office or from the governor or from the local regional leadership, is a concern regarding land grabbing. There's a problem of land grabbing and high demand for plots and unfortunately limited available service areas for applicants. The municipality sits with 1,000, over 16,000 applications for airmen compared to the 1,000 available airmen. So 16,000 people, one airman, and the available is only 1,000. So you can see the serious challenge for land. And of course, the feedback is that the municipality of Katina Murillo is currently unable to expand its boundaries because of the dispute that exists between the town council and the Mafwe traditional authority over some areas adjacent to the municipality. And of some of the residents who are occupying that land, they say that they have received their allocation from the Mambwe Traditional Authority because the Mambwe Traditional Authority understand that they have jurisdiction over that area. So this issue is being addressed by the relevant offices. Moving on to the business community, they raise a number of issues. One concern were raised with respect to the decreasing number of tourists visiting the region. So this is an interesting phenomenon because nationally we have seen the number of tourists visiting Namibia rising from 1.3 million to 1.4 million between 2015 and 16 respectively. So maybe the region through the local regional leadership and stakeholders must do something to reactivate interest in the region because we are aware that most of the time tourists come through to go to Botswana or from Botswana to go back to Belgium. So we need to create attractions within and around the Katima Merino area and surrounding area so that at least they can stay for a night or two. So the challenge remains to the local leadership and the residents of the region to work together to create more attractive opportunities for tourists. The second concern was the awarding of public tenders. The concern across most of the regions we have been to still is the regional leadership seems not to give preference to local businesses when procuring goods and services. We can only advise that in terms of the Public Procurement Act, the Zambezi Regional Council and all the local institutions of government must comply with the provisions of the Procurement Act, which says that preference must be given to local service providers. Of course, business people must also come to the party and offer competitive prices so that they are not outdone to the competition by people from outside. But we know the challenges our business people face, and therefore the local and regional leadership must also assist to capacitate our local business people, especially SMEs, so that they are able to rise to the requirements of competitive pricing. In addition, recently the Ministry of Finance issued a directive to all the regions that when we are procuring, we must purchase local content. So business people, please be on the lookout and make sure when you are putting in your tender for the supply of goods and services that we will be outperforming other people who may come from elsewhere. The third issue raised by the business community was that trade volumes between Namibia and Zambia are increasing, and the Zambians now have significant purchasing power. They wanted to see how the government can help to ensure and facilitate the ease of movement of people and currency. All we can say is that at the moment the Zambian culture is not traded, unlike when there was an agreement between Namibia and Angola to make the Kwanza changeable locally. This is not the case with the Kwacha, the Zambian Kwacha. And Katima Mulilo at the moment has got a number of commercial, all four commercial banks have got branches here, and there's also a bureau of change in town. So for now, we advise our business people to use those formal channels. The volumes might be increasing, but from the sustainability and viability point of view, may not yet have reached a stage where the two governments can consider a currency trading agreement. The fourth and last point raised by the business community was and remains access to financing. So the feedback is as follows, that in order to overcome the hurdle of non-collateralized lending, government has established several funding grants and schemes in the different offices, ministries and agencies. This includes, amongst others, the new credit scheme available in the Ministry of Sport, Youth and National Service, the Women's Development Fund at the Ministry of Gender, Equality and Child Welfare, the Youth Credit Scheme available at the National Youth Council, and the Equipment Aid Scheme and the Ministry of Industrialization, Trade and SME, as well as non-collateralized financing products and agribank. So a lot of progress has been made, and it is up to us now to access those facilities, and of course to make sure that when we get access to those facilities, we do everything we can to pay back so that those involving facilities can also benefit those who come behind us. Furthermore, the government through the Development Bank of Namibia has established 4 new financing instruments, and these instruments have been capitalized to the tune of $100 million. These are the Venture Capital Fund, the Credit Guarantee Scheme, the Challenge Account, which focuses mainly on mentorship, business mentorship program, and the Skills Lending Facility for Entrepreneurs. All these are available. We must do our part to be able to access them. The last stakeholders to raise issues were the farmers. And number one issue they raised was the question, what is government doing to solve the problem of foot and mouth disease, which we know is prevalent in this region? The thing done is that the veterinary services in the Ministry of Agriculture, Water and Forestry continues with the mandatory free vaccination of cattle in the region. And as a result, the vaccination figure shows the high rate of coverage. In 2015, through this vaccination program, they were able to cover 94% of the livestock population in the region. This improved to 95.7% in 2016, and then was a slight decline to 94.4% in 2017. So I think here government has done a lot and continue to do a lot to try and limit the issue of foot and mouth disease. And government is committed to continue to provide resources to continue with the vaccination program. At the moment, Namibian farmers buy their vaccines from Botswana. There is therefore constant engagement with the Botswana Vaccine Institute in order to ensure that the vaccines that are bought meet the Namibian standards. And recently, Namibia sent samples to the Botswana Vaccine Institute in order to check for, in case of outbreak of foot and mouth diseases, and to assess the form of viruses affecting cattle in the region. And if the vaccine is right, or the correct one, to fight the virus. And I think so far the vaccine board from Botswana has been certified as being correct. However, the ministry is engaging stakeholders and to look at whether a vaccine processing plan can be established in the region to assist the farmers, which will also assist the farmers in the region to improve the marketing of their cattle. Finally, from the farmers was the concern that portable water solutions were required. And the feedback is that since 2015, 12 boreholes have been drilled. In total, 603 boreholes have been drilled in the region. Covering the other areas are covered with pipelines, from Katima Mulilo to Bukalo, Katima Mulilo to Simbita, and Katima Mulilo to Minyanti and Maunga. So this is what has been done. These were the issues that were posed, and therefore we hope that when the engagement session starts, that the stakeholders will be given an opportunity to raise issues will take into account the progress that has been made so far before they put same or related questions. And since there are so many people who may wish to put questions to His Excellencies and His Ministers, what we have been saying is that please, as His Excellency have said, be brief. Your submissions are written and we will receive them, we will take note of them and we will action them as we have done. But be mindful that you give chance to as many people as possible to put forward their questions, and then also to allow time for His Excellency and the ministers, Prime Minister and Vice President, to also respond to some of the questions you may have. Your Excellency, this is the end of the meeting.
Now, second part of because now the Prime Minister to talk about drought.
Thank you very much, Your Excellency. May I extend on the protocol already established and only extend the greetings to everyone. Yes, the drought relief program of the government aims to provide support to households as well as to animals as a result of the drought that has affected both food production for humans, the availability of water, and also grazing for animals. In this regard, the government has provided food to households. You are aware that we have established a threshold to qualify to benefit from the drought relief food in order for us to ensure that we prioritize those that are most needy, especially given the fact that the government is short of funding to provide support to everyone that would otherwise need support from government. This is in spite of the fact that we have approved a large budget of $570 million for drought relief, and we have done our best to source in excess of $400 million towards the financing of this budget. We still have a shortfall on that budget, and we are observing also that the initial number of people needing support from government is estimated would be overshot significantly. Within this region, we are expecting that the 8,302 households would need support as opposed to only 2,532 households that we had estimated would need support from the government. And therefore, with this budget that we have, even when considering the more than $104 million that we have raised through donations from foreign governments, international organizations, corporate entities here in Namibia, and also contributions from individuals who responded to the call of the government to contribute 2% of their basic annual income towards the drought relief program, we are still far short of what we need to cater for everyone. So I reiterate the call of the government for us to understand the request of government for us to allow those that are most destitute to stand at the front of the queue for support in order for us to ensure that no one dies of hunger. I also reiterate the call of our government is also made by Comrade President, that those of us that have not yet made our contribution is requested should please consider to do that, because really charity starts at home. If other people have agreed to support and they have done so, and they have not done that because they have too much money that they know what to do with, they did that just out of solidarity with us, we should also come forth and support our own compatriots. At the end of the day, even if we do not directly benefit by receiving food or fodder or subsidies, the injection into the economy that would resuscitate the growth of the economy would still benefit us directly and indirectly through the provision of the services that we have outlined previously. We want government to extend to us that we are still not yet receiving. We also provide support towards the availing of water, both for human consumption and also for animals, through the provision of water using water tankers, the installation of equipment at boreholes, and also the rehabilitation of boreholes. Of course, the normal program for water provision through the Ministry of Agriculture, Water and Forestry through pipelines is also ongoing. We also have a livestock support program that consists of the supply of free fodder for farmers whose income is within the threshold as established, and also whose animal heads is within the threshold as established. We provide livestock marketing incentives to encourage farmers to destock. I know that the abattoir is still being constructed. It is not yet finished. And also the processing plant is still to be established, but we are encouraging farmers where there are opportunities for us to cull our animals to take advantage of that, especially now that the government has decided that the sourcing by public institutions within the communal areas for food products is going to be done from within those areas so that we can provide markets for produce from these areas. We also provide subsidies for fodder and or leaks to qualifying farmers, and in this regard we have received some claims which have been processed. Those claims that have not yet been processed would be processed as soon as the verification process has been completed, and we also encourage those that are considering to source this fodder to do so and benefit from the subsidy scheme. We provide subsidies for transportation to grazing areas and also subsidies for leasing of grazing areas. We have noted that the distribution of food has commenced. We have delivered the supplies for up to the end of August, already in June, in order to make sure that there are no delays caused by logistical issues. We noted that because of the high number of verified households that will need support compared to what was initially estimated, we would need to increase the supplies for food starting from next month. And there should therefore be no concerns. Our only request would be for us to ensure that those that are registered to benefit are those that meet the threshold as established. And the food package in this regard consists of maize meal, tinned fish, and cooking oil. I am very happy to see that at some of our green schemes, we are now also producing some of this food, and also that we have established capacity for milling, so that we make sure that as much as possible, the funds that are utilized to implement this drought relief really filters through to the rest of the regional economy and inject life in the regional economy. We have also availed public transportation from the Defense Force. Three trucks have been availed for each region, including this region. And the Defense Force personnel are also available to assist with the loading and offloading of food. We noted last time that there was not enough manpower in this regard, and the Ministry of Defense has committed itself to avail additional personnel, and I understand that has happened. So this should help to ease whatever challenges we are facing in implementing the program. We also noted the concern related to the state of repair of some of the transport that was availed to the regions, and we have as a result availed $500,000 to the Zambezi region, as we have done for other regions, to take care of any repairs that would be required to make sure that the program runs smoothly. In regard to water provision, we have provided $3 million to the Zambezi Regional Council to take care of the water provision issues, as I alluded to them previously. So by having the money provided to the Regional Council, we are hoping that we would mitigate against any delays, and also that we are able to achieve efficiency in terms of pricing for any services that would have to source to do the rehabilitation of the boreholes and the equipping of the boreholes. We noted the concerns that were expressed previously because of the limit of the farmers that would qualify for free fodder to 250. This was done because of resources constraints, and these constraints still remain, but we have decided to show flexibility by allowing that all the farmers that meet the criteria of a monthly income per household and also size of the animal heads should be registered. We will do our best to cater for them within the resources that are available, but we will be limited by the resources that are available. So if we can respond as a community to support by contributing whatever we can, monetary and otherwise, to the drought relief program, then we will be in a better position to assist our compatriots that are in need of support. This is the summary that I have in regard to drought relief.
Thank you very much. I'm just about to finish my speech. There are items that we discovered are going to come up during the other session, question and answers, like land delivery, house, sanitation, to old age and social grants, and human wildlife conflict. Those ones we know is going to come up. So I'll stop here now and wait until we come to that. With that, we have come to now my speech, to the end of my speech. I want me now we are going to allow people to translate. We can all listen. Those who want to move around, on the minister to go out to what the end can do now. Those who don't understand the language. So now it's over to you.
Thank you, Your Excellency. Mr. Samuel Wuchane will do our translation.
Thank you very much for the honor and privilege given to me. I will quickly translate. His Excellency Dr. Hagegenko summary. I'll try to do it as quick as possible and brief. It's written in English. I'll translate it to Silozi as it is. Mukoloko kiwaleta wazee mzene kuna kufitiswa ma na kuwate kuwa mwete wana na kote zisikiriti mize kima emu wakuta ni mafari na neo zene kuna kutisezwa ma mkopano wa simo so 2015 mo mwete wana na vile ni mkopano ni chalo maske kisa Zambezi kuzee sika hii kawaleta wazene kuna kuwa mbola na hini zame hatu wakua atalike uzo zamu suni isika mwa mani chono tekiswa wali 44 na tekiswa wazezu wakari 44 za 9 ka ma ikuto ba tozene filo za kuwa ya kwa lito uze 90 maske seza bezma na kwa hili kana limu ze taro kwa iye kuhi ya kitaba zine kona la kuwa ze nevilaiza manicho de zoro pili ya komano ma haraka temba tolpa ya kati mamre ni kuta ya mafwe pari muharita wa za mungu iye tokota tulo ka pili pili ili tawa hivyo na la kuwa eti sabu niya mazwa ukini mazwa utakati mamilu mani chwao ni Namibia ka kule ka miliani ya likomu kuzwa na kuzwana hane kuna nilita wazi mzene ya ambozu kuzwana kukona kukisa sivaka kukona kupangwa miliani kwa ena na masikili tawa mwena tawa hivyo na la kuwa eti ya inyani kati yao kuzwa wakuto kwa wana mpikawe uzee mani choro ni skili sasa bezi mo kubonisakuri ma company za 139 nafiwe matenders ama shilling ala tolika 97,895,46 masimo sa 2015-2019 ni maemo alina neoze kikuta alipatuta wazine pone
please let us not empty the hall even the facilities outside will not accommodate all of us at the same time let us settle in and listen and also respect the language being spoken thank you
mize liambola zene kuna tokuzona mamuko pano wakala 5 August mwasumo 2015 kwa Zambezi Town kwa kwa Zambezi Community Hall wono kalirekana kwa ya 9 o'clock isa na kwa ya 4 o'clock mwone kubire ni linga mbolo za liwa wanze supile mi hato ni mamola manga tangata na hapo na kufitiswa kuzwa tiko tomu huso manchwa ni umuto kwa mahali ngambolo ze kwa lati hali ngambolo ni kuna ni vene mae mela likuwa tapata za sichaba kabalancha basali basupali likuta za sizo sichaba sali pisi nisi balibi balikeleke batu wapia mwanga nubo hole wala zwa mama lazika pa likawo za sicha wazaveni wa kumbolezo wa tuko mani chua ni kama reso ya tutengo tuwa milonga ni milonga nyana mi kuwa ncha ni sabaza pili zende fitisizwe ki kuisi wa kwa mlilo wa magiesi mwaliba kazi mataka nyani kukusi ya wako kufuma ye mwa hapu tisifa fasi kalako kuze kikuli ni haa kuisi wa kwa lisebele uze kumama ye mwa azama akabunya zele tisu waka utata mbubulite ni mana konie wa sifumu ni kufuma na hali sewezo zeto kwa alama kuisa sewezo mburi wa makezi kono ni haku lichua lorikolo ze silezi selifu manikare li sewezo mburi wa makezi tuwa simosa 2015 ze mhape ki likolo ze nyani ni ma hostels mani chua lo ni maino alabancha sinabungatwa wana na hawa apelizo kuzama nisipige mitele ya pali polo kalapo kuzee likolo zepe liko nebu ya hiyo maske ni sasa mbezi ka sponsors tuwa leka ndolo memorial hofu ya hiyo hostel mi kuya hiyo kumiserizu wa mginzi fa 67% ni sponsor luhono nosia ezu hostel mi miserizu wa 25% kuya mafelo amiserizi kusabate ni kwa mavoni kwa wakolo ambo la mavo tumato kwa kati mamrilo mi halo ze rubre la fa kawato kuze upone kuya iwa mavoni kwa katima sports complex masumosa 2017 ye mukwari nongezele fitsizwe kikusa bate ni kwa mezi ni mulilo magesi kwa sawa kasema na kosemu ni kubanga cho kulikube ni mulilo magesi hakuna ni bae teleli kwa mibuso kalabu kuye kwa kuzo ye kiakuli mezi ni mulilo magesi mwari na kosemu lipumi wanga kaba kabati yeho ya kusakira kwa lisele lozuzeni maikuto ama mwi na hili akuli baba nchi hawafuma ni liselezo zeeva toka kuzwa mouth purpose youth, youth center mei kalago kuzee kiakuli palo ya baba ncha baba ni mwari kolo wa sabiriki mwa sideri kolo wa fitera 171 kiwene mafibe zivo ya kuitu sama computers meiva 88 sewafuma ni zivo hape wa msewezi ya kulwa hali ya palo kuzwa mouth purpose youth center kuzwa sema sa 2015 kusabate ni kwa center ya Coastake manicho ni high vocational training center mwa Zambezi kalabo kuze kia kuli ni hapu sina Coastake maskete sa Zambezi kuna ni Zambezi vocational training center ZVTC yeo kie mwiali kolo zepeli mo kuna ni lisevele zuzani tuto za maemu hapa hani michwa nungufama sa mwa sa 2015 na yuko na yuko zibeha zwari tuto zencha zechwa zibo ya pitu sari vile kiswa za jimo mani cho ni zibo ya kuchara miloho nize nitisa paro yari tuto zefio kwa skolose kutolifa nai mi maituti mabanga atakiwe ni maimu osize kwa skolosa za Zambezi Vocational Training Center kama maituti mba 654 kwa maimu osize michwa mfala 270 kasi mwasa 2019 baafeli zetu toza kona kwa haba sali nekuna ni kalulo ya kufa mipuzo kwa ama tichere tabaye mwona hala kubwa yes kama ya mwasa kata kono kalabo kuze mwuso kasi mwasa 2016 ni ikatengu kawona za kama iso kapatika emela matichere kana ntu ni bafiti ya tumela noya kweke za rituwe wa zawa kwenye kwa mwuso matichere ka 9% mizene liko ndo kutise zo kala wani lo mkasi mwazo 2017 kuya yoko mandu mwata mkoloko wa mass housing ni kutula kwa mandu wa ni iba sali baba na nita kazo ya kuu sali baka za maya helo kono bato kwa limbo ya zeko na kwa lume na kweze se karavu mandu wa 203 ako ndo kuya yoko mwata mkoloko wa mass housing maski ni sasa mbezi ni hapo leo kwa 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 tukuzo sa mwaza 2015-2019 hapo leo kama shiringi ama hala 200,000 kwa 500,000 ni hape katengo ka konde kukena matumela no ni tutengo tuwa nisewezi ya kwa mponda kuitamasi ni kaniku ya ama ndu ama mamangata kama ndu wa 103 ya kwa mkoloko wa kuya hiwa asafiri zwekare ni 187 sekuna ni batu mi kuna nita wa zee mzee peri zee ni kuna kufitiswa kaa kushuta na mwani sivezo za makete kutoka mawoki ringaka mwani pata za mguso nukulu melo kwa kakuli mwani pata zee mzee nzi mwole mi kuzee kusafu mana cholo ni kwe mami bamba emi telele kwa lipata za mguso Nivelikso ze ngata za nisimeno zoma kete niko neku ya hiwa maskiliti kako wa makuwa ipata nyana ze chwale kause se ngoma nikaenda ze neko neku nangoa kwa ya kama emu ripate la kuko na kuna waba kuri ni kukwa wa sumuguso kala mwakweli ya lungu kasi mwasa 2019 ni hape kuna ni dina neho za zene zibarisizwe Zambia haspatela sabaima nize niliko niku mate mwakweli ya sobe mwase mwase 2019 kwa kalabu ya kuto kwa lingaka uko niku vani tukiso za kuisa lingaka mwa lipatela ze nanuzu fama emo ze kwa likasi bindasa mwa lini ukalo kuna ni machazi wa mazuya na Cuba baba kono kenyo misewezi kasi ni katisi ni mwana Cuba ni na Namibia miba baiza misewezi yetu alika pazwa Recebeu os olhos ali, pediatrician, manitou no pa Miliani, Erika Lapo, Zameno. Mizere, litisize, kukuzua kwa kuru melaba kulipi ya kupata zemu, manitou nilita mazemu zeka taza maima. So, mama yemo, wino makuta ako, ni kufukuza pao ya mafu, kakutu alimu mwiki, ya na timezi kakipiwa zetu liwe, ma sini mwose sifedile mwona. Mizere, mifukuze, nisewezi kafra ka 70%. Kuko ni kupolwa, private dialysis, spatela, sesifari kalafo, kwa alipio, tuwa nufa maskini sasa bezi. Mizikiriti, sindesiseweza, nina hafa maemo hapa hami, kwekeza maemo, hafa nisiweza uzoma kete. Maana na bibi ya kari na neo za kuisa mwaka, maali bakazari pata za mwuso. Baba mwona za kuta tuvali, tava za makete, maatope ya katimamulo, hapafi, maemo atoko melo, wata waze kataza. Suhu maali bakazana ikaela zetu wani kachoto kambo ima mwoma. Mwos, chavane sikilaya kama uli. Kami kwa kwa chile chile maali bakazana na ikaela. Mika wu kuye kukwa maemu haki akuli. Mubuso uziba lita maze konele kufitiswa. Nikuli mikuwa kwa yache vechile mwari wakazana ikahela. Kiniti itisa lita maze muze kwa nakustata za maemu ama kete. Kono ni akuli chwalo, kuna ni imi leo ya kuruksa limbaka. Mo limbaka za sinelezo, mani chwa kuna la maemu alivu wakazana ikahela. Ni kufani sebelu zetu wa waka na kuhanzi hiya. Miku ama mezi avuva, mezi ama sila avuva, maatropa ya katima mbilo. Katiko katolopo, kapa tele kukenisa, mikoko lomba yeza maesa mezi ama sila, mani cholo ni lukisa hande, ma suwa manholes, kutivera utata po, kwa kufuva kwa mezi. Ama sama troko. Mize rivanga teni kazazi. Kwa rava tuve neva kungulezi kwa tuko. Kwa fali mwatawa ye, neri kuli vaveleki kapa zenga tazika ezwa kutivela kusaluma mviwa kwa iso na uzaba veleki. Ilimo vaveleki vatari manangane lita waza unatua kapa mani nyandiso mama zoa wama beriksa. Mi kwa taba ye kalamu kiakuli, kuna ni kutoko totungata nata, totu luksizwe, totu vona za liswana uzama beriki. Mi liswana uzama beriki hali kone kuruwa uviwa. Tutengo totu na nubi kalameo wapona kutani mafari taba ze. Mi sisi sivilo kikuli mwendi matuka wana zivo. Ya alinzi la zona nukula telela kapa tutengo towa na nikuiko pa ya nitona hapa tovani tutoze gacholo makansi la zona niteni vayetele vali kutozozo wala tuzo la pili kufari itabaze kwa sichama kwa makuwa kuna kumanaki tutoze cholo basu pali palo ya raisi yezwa kwa simu ya Karimbeza itulide ahuru kwa sichama kamutara 50 kg yele kapa $500. Kalabo, palo ya raisi ya Karimbeza ifa $11.50 kilogram. Mi kapeko 50 kg ifa $575. Mi zeni machualo ka riteko za misika. Kaba mani kalo evo na zaka maiso ze. Mi hape sicha wa sitive kuli, kuna ni zeni nata ze, uze mkona kutisa ze, kamta. Kalisi nyeo ze vateni, ka ze chwale ka mezi, kulilomba kesi. Menu no mane chuo ni misewezi ye na kwezuma. Kuzumiwa kwa liye mbele, ki iba ya iba na Zambia, kwa kuruge lo kwa wai tengile kwa tawa ze. Kalabu, kaku wa tawa ye zibahala, hakuna liye mbele ze fumane maari wa kaze sireza ni koko zona ni maski msaza bezi. Kono na yaku lichoro palo, ya lito uze 19 kizene kwa hiyo maski msaza bezi. Mahala simu sa 2017-2019. Me 2017 palo ya watu wa kuruwe na wasele tuwa ni watamilwe ni kukukuza kwa lita mazabu sumi isikamu wa wakame hatu ene tiselizwe ki kukupiwa kwa haka temo kukabu na za selerezo ya kukolo kolo za nae manager maspokola ni maso lebana na mipya baba potari ba kabo kulwa ko ba dirike zo zecholo kuba tatawaza utwa macho ni pati so ukone kutisa kuko ndeko batse ni fama yemwa mande mahala alikolo lebona za sirezo alfo fozo na yinde maspokola me kutisize kutamio ko batu bakata baba kulwa ko ba itegire ma tegiso ya zezo kwari for four zana ya maha likuwe nize sika ya zefere mutata wakuto kwa lisevelezo za mkwito ya NBC manecholo ni mafone ya fanoka halamo kuze kiakuri 82.3% ya sichara masket sa Zambezi mafumanali sevelezo kuzwa kwa MTC ni Telecom kari direkso ze ya hiyo kwa Telecom Maybe it was in 2015, my towers are 6K now on air. Kuya hiwa, niku kalapi tusiswa, wale watazetu wale kama futa ibu, bala sinte itomba. Sikanji ya mukani, ngalamwe. Me, kwa amari, sivele uzaba NBC. Kapi wakuzwa, likolo, likuona za zivu ya tabakaswa sana wa mihala. Nisupaku lipalwa batu, Mas que se Zambezi, bafumanali sevelezo ze luxizo za digital television DDT. Zoma transmitters kama tu, bafumanali sevelezo ze ka 54%. Mugusi siwa skiriti. Dita wa ze rivani ni kukungela mugu, iska mulao, kusabate ni kuma plotsi, amangata amaya helo, manito aneliku kwa zabatu wapitsa, kuto kwa kuyahamani. Kalabo kuze, Kini tukulikuna ni kushuta na maikuto mahala kati mba tolopo ya kati mamilo ni kuta ya mafwe. Kaba tulopo muhimu wa tolopo ya kati mamilo wa ikungezi mufu iska mula mba soa kuna paka kati wakuli mafilo mufu uchwa kikuta. Bize ikone kutisa kuli baba filo mufu kikati mba tolopo ya kati mamilo. Bapare lwe kuteza misebezi ya mwona kavu nako. Meili kololeni kuna zazulo pili alimba kazafu kuwa ni mataka nyani ni ofisi ya mzikisiyo mvulu manichwa ni ofisi ya mvulu sisi ni katekwe kama iso security makini mataka ye miifumana ifumani maemo apili mataka ze kutokwa kwa asi chama sani bisinisi kuvile ni kukute na kufasi kwa makoti masikiriti meze likona kwa piswa kwa libele kisoze liteni kari wakazama tivele lo hava poti meikari kaspa losesifiwe mahala simo za 2015 kia 2016 mapoti mapiti ya 1,387,773 ni 1,469,528 Ibaka za matide lo manchwa na li tolo. Kufuwa kama tenders. Fatawa ye, makapa ni za 139, kene afiwe matenders kari tawaze fiwe. Maskiri tisa Zambezi. Meika tengo kakama iso askiri tisa Zambezi. Kana ni pita makomula wa omo na zafa matenders. Kapa sivele uzamo muso. Wa act number 15 wa simo sa 2015. After hapa kufa matenders. Me tekiso mahala na Namibia na Zambia fa halipo ata wa ye kikuli kuna ni ripanka zene ze ni mwato lopo ya kati mamulio baana ni maluko wana za kama iso ya mashirini kachwalo wa ya hiba na Zambia ni hawa pale wa kuleka hivya na Zambia kama shirini kwacha watu wa kati mamulio kikuli mashirini ana hae ana ni kumulisu wa kwa panka ya na Namibia mi mutata mungu wa kufuma na risevelezo za mashirini kie mgalita ze kone kufitiswa mi kelezo kiakuli Kuna ni zengata, ze kuna tokiwa ki maripanga, mbukona kuitamasi mtani kufari sero ze chwa wakono. Nyaku chwa mbuso, nitu kutu mtu wakuto kwa wakone fa lituso. Ze chwa leka liberekiso, ni ze mkwa wancha, machwa masari, ni likolo wancha, ni lisebelezo za sichana. Kwa balimi, buzo neri ya kuli katibu buso wezangi mwakuta tulu la mutata wa utuku wa taku ni mulomu. Karabo kuzeki ya kuli likolo levo na sirezo ya limunanu, dezurapini ni witamo wakufa mipende ya mahala ukona kuwansa utuku wa saku wa mama security. Me kase mwaza 2015 kulume wa kuli msevezi huko nekuza mahande ka 94% ni 95.75% mwaza 2016 ni 94.4% mwaza 2017 me mutata wa mezi ake nile ma liwa kaze mweza mataka nyani kalabu kuze kiakuli liwa ze to kize kuna kuya hiwa kuzwa silmosa 2016 nekuti saparo ya liwa ze ya hilo kutolefa 603 maskiriti mize kukone kuwa nimi hatu hape ya kuisa mapipe abu kisa meza ake nile kuzwa tolope ya kati mamri ukulima kukalo kuzwa tolope ya kati mamri ukulima asiwa kasa spida ni kati mamri ukulima linyanti ni maunga mize kyo nalitawa ze supa maemo alinonge ze nekono kufetuswa maski kisaza mbezi ni tumezi I'm given a tough task here, but I have to carry it out. Kwa nafa maemu Rinanda. Kala 19 ni diachamani kasili mwosa 2019. Katengo ka makuwa huyu na kanya tezimo hato wakupa rituso za Rinanda. Ma mikoloko yetu alika kufa licho, kufa mezi, kufa aliteko zeri mpuvo, za alimu nanu, kufa mali, haku tizo fafasi, alinzila. Kwa amalimi, mali makazi mafulisezo. Mane chualo ni kufa mali, haku tizo fafasi, akuleksa licho za alimu nanu. Mi kala 3 lungu kasi mwasa 2019 maitele wanaha na hako nekuzivaha za maemo au ino waputako fahari kuino waninaha mi mvuso huko nekulukisa masharing afite la $5 million haka toko mamusirizu ho kari neolo zemu zeko nekufiwa kiva neoleli wakwande kama sharingi nilivya na kutusa mvuso kukona kwa lava ya kwani tawaze ni kutoli faa maemu ante nchwa nungu faa $59.8 million kiese kone kusevili suwa makuleka ze utopa kaya nicho za alimu nanu mani chwa ni kutusa tutengo tu wata maeso ya likiriti kutusa mali mikuleka nicho za alimu nanu za mwona Meskili sasa business filo mashiringi awa tori kana $3 million mahala nina neo za 2019-2020 maa mkoloko wa kutusa mama yemo a dinanga mi kukone kuyepi wa liliva ze lishumi kaze ketazo 15 maa liva kaze tori kasipinda kabe yemo mtulo kabe yemo mbola Skiriti Silalanda sa katima ima mataganya ni Judea ya Poloma ni Silalanda sa Rinyanti. Mi ofisi ifire tayo kwa rikolo la jimo mezi ni mishitu kukona kuitama kwa kusebeli samari ama tuweka na $3 million makuisa sebelezo za mezi. Mutata wa rinanga maskiriti za Zambezi mwona kwa mwoguni mwogo watoswa na ni skiriti za maheke ni ipunene kwa ni mwona taba zielizwe ki wino wa rinanga mi hakuna likomu zedi ilo kubazi sevula iwe ki maemu alina na maskiriti ni haase uke na manako ya siri ya matelo wa siri mwa kweli ya September ni October mwa 2019 mbali mima 24 kutoli na koni ye kivesi wa imo sise kufuma nani tuso wata salina neose me palo yali munanu zema tolika na 243 kizese elexizwe ka mashilingi ama tolika na 97,200 ka yefiro kwa abalimi kwa ma dicho za riko kama limunanu kukone kwa viwa licho za limunano zeba tolika na 2,225 zee kone ufiwa kikatengo kaka maisho wa sikiriti merifiro kwa awali mwa sikiriti ka sirikani kapa maringamo zee kone kubate mwa hala katengo kabali mine katengo kaka maisho wa sikiriti merinaneo zee nerikane kala 25 July mwasa mwasa 2019 me skip sasa busy seeing what zeba atoka tolika na 8302 kama basi ababa tokwa lituso za putako mahala batu wa 41,510 me maimo kwa haka temu kabona za wino wa putako matasa ya nilu kwa hili mleka maofisi ya gade ya wana me skiriti sifumani mafola mafola kwa pesa ma 750 bills are 5,064 ne tu saka twa mpyu to 5,064 twa matoko ma 5 cages ne lita pize ne yu mama kapaze 50,384 manichualo ne lituso zemu zari choze kone kwa 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 chana sepa pa harimu a maimu alinanga kwa wazazi ukona kisa
that is now our accountability board. You cannot deny we came to account. Maso we're ending here now. Over to the director of ceremony to take over and now start the new report and debate. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Can we give a hand to the address of the guest? Thank you. Thank you. I believe my work has been made easier for the next section of the proceedings. The presentations which have been made might have already answered to some of the questions which our communities had intended to ask. So I hope that you had listened very carefully. What I mean is that when you come to the podium, if the issue was already raised or answered or responded to already just now, please do not raise it. We have it already written and it was already responded. Focus on any new question which might not have been touched from any of the explanations which have been given. We really appreciate. We will be taking questions from those who have registered. First 10 questions and then we'll get responses. I would like to again request that the people who will be speaking should be very brief. We are giving 3 minutes. 3 minutes. No long speeches. Get to the point. We have your submission. It's going to be made. So if you can focus on the key questions in your submission, it will help us to proceed. Cooperate with me. At certain points, I will have to cut you if it goes beyond the required time. We will start with our traditional leaders. We will start with our traditional leaders. Then we would actually move to those who have registered for questions. I'll start with the Mafwe traditional authority. Protocol, can you please guide them to the next podium?
Traditional authority that the Tunga would not attend gathering like this. Even if the traditional authority is always in his royal house, I attend all matters. So that's why he's not here. I'm representing the Mafwe traditional authority. Your Excellency, the traditional authority wants that put up the label that we appreciate and sincerely appreciate the government of the Republic of Namibia in its government programs. We really thank you, the government, because you have brought quite a lot of development in our area. We cannot count them. because every counting, something new is happening. So we sincerely thank you. However, we want to bring the following challenges forward. It's rampant in Zongola and Spinda constituents. I don't want to mention statistics which are from your office, Your Excellency. There are none. The youth unemployment is also rampant. We have so many dropouts of schools that are in villages, and this rely on their families and their parents to feed them and to upgrade them. Rural electrification, we still say thank you, but doesn't cover every part of my area of jurisdiction. It's only in pockets here and there. The rest of the country is still, or the community, they still rely on wood and can do right their homes. Lack of market, and here I'm going to speak mainly livestock markets, because I can't speak of crop market because we didn't harvest anything this year. Our farmers, with all their livestock, are starving because they don't have any market for their livestock. And this is also perpetuating poverty among our people. Drought. Yes, drought, Your Excellence. It's grave. Very serious drought. At my age, I haven't seen drought of this magnitude in the Zambezi region. We normally have drought, but it's limited to crops. But this year's drought affects not only people, but livestock and even wildlife. That's how severe the drought. And we thank you for all the interventions the government should be. But we need more. I'll be brief, I'm just jumping around because 3 minutes is not enough. Lack of water, Comrade President, is also very severe. Most of the river beds closer to people have died, so they have to go long distance to collect water from the river, those who are next to the rivers. Water is also affecting our livestock. Village like Spinda had to stay for 1 month without water. The water point which has been provided by Water Fest is only for human consumption, but their livestock is also coming there, and that makes it a very serious problem. And this is what we need, some intervention soon. Your Excellency, we call for an accelerated infrastructure development. Here we mention, I think there's a program that I had in this meeting, which I don't want to repeat, of water, of borehole drilling. The only thing that we need is that at least, as a traditional authority, we have the custodian over the communal land. We need to be consulted, to be informed where the government will be going. And this is the lack of consultation between the traditional authority and the two tier of government here in the Zambezi region has led to the current problem that we have with the town council. Because we are never consulted in any way. By now, Your Excellency, we want to say once more, and we say sincerely, we will support every government activity. We also need to be consulted, or even informed if we don't get to be consulted. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Honorable Ngambela, we invite the Mashi Traditional Authority. They will be followed by the Masubia and Maye.
Thank you, Your Excellence. I'd like to stand on the protocol that is already established. I then come to the point. When I was coming to this meeting, I was told by my chief, my name is Richard Limbino, representing my traditional. I was told by my chief to request, if the jet is going back to tomorrow, the request is, can His Excellency lower down to that place and see how people are competing for water. We've got a very, very serious water crisis in Congola, particularly in a place that is called Choi. Since it's independence, there's no water. People are not in the Namibian house. I just wanted to start from the bottom because this is famine. If people have got no water and there's drought, people are going to die. They need water. Where in the place of food, maybe they may need water for their survival. I put number one. This year, we had a demonstration that it demanded water, but there was no response from the office in the region. And this is also pending and disappointing. Number one, that may be linked why people don't attend, is how. This is a question that goes to His Excellence. How is the other people not represented in the parliament? That the president knows that the other tribes that are outside the Namibian laws have not been represented in the parliament. Not even one representing them. That is why even the call or the cry of the people is done. Nobody will listen to them. This is not tribalism. How long would the government consider the place that was made for the Kamenga, that was a battlefield, to upgrade it to the national heritage? In order to make a remembrance to the people we're fighting there, as it is done in other places. We are looking forward to see that place is upgraded to the national heritage. The other issue that I will not mention, the issue of water. There's a promise that I had in the speech that water will be given to people. But how long is it going to take? Because if the people are just like that, we may have a catastrophe of people dying. And we need an attention. Very urgent attention to be attended to this issue. Thank you very much. The submission, where a lot of things mentioned, can I submit?
Thank you, thank you, thank you very much, my traditional authority. Thank you very much. We have the Masubia traditional authority.
Thank you very much. May I stand on the protocol as established? My name is Albius Melinda Kamu Ngambela of the Masubia Traditional Authority. Your Excellency, the Masubia Traditional Authority extends its greetings to Your Excellency and wishes you longevity and good health. We express our appreciation and gratitude for Your Excellency's expressed policy of inclusivity, or Harambe, and a champion against poverty among your people. In this regard, we highly appreciate the support given to our senior citizens, as well as orphans and vulnerable children. We also express our appreciation and gratitude for the development projects in our areas of jurisdiction since independence. Your Excellency, please rest assured of our uncompromising support to the policy of the legacy continues. In this regard, as in the past, our support, Your Excellency, is as solid as a rock. Now, therefore, the Masubia Traditional Authority would like to put forward the following issues or requests. The road to Honono be named Brandon Simbwaye Highway. This road passes through the village of our national hero, Brandon Kangongolo Simbwaye. The government should urgently attend to the plight of drought victims who qualify for drought relief and already registered, but are currently not receiving support in terms of food relief. The government should urgently provide a market for livestock, since meat was pulled out from the Zambezi region about 5 years ago. The people of this region have been suffering. In this regard, we request urgent action from our Sopo party government. Both the Katimo Mlilo Abattoir and Bukalo meat processing plant should be up and running as soon as possible in order for the people of the region to benefit and alleviate from the effects of drought. The Katimo Mlilo Ngoma pipeline should be completed as soon as possible. This pipeline has taken more than 10 years to be completed, and yet it used to be budgeted for every year. The Kapewa Kabajani River Transport Boat from Katima Mlilo to Impalila Island should be operational in order to ease the plight of the citizens of the island. The government purchased the boat for this purpose more than 10 years ago. In addition, a dredger was purchased, and yet to date the boat is not operational. Our support party government should ensure that the Zambezi region is truly a bread basket of Namibia. Currently, the only government green scheme project, Kalimbeza Rice, is up for outsourcing to the private sector. And yet, less than 10 million Namibia dollars is needed each year to make it fully operational and expanded. We also plead for more green schemes, the green scheme projects in the region. We kindly request our Swakopmund government to open up the Bukalo Channel so as to provide water to both humans, human and animals. The project used to be budgeted for by the Minister of Agriculture, Water and Forestry more than 10 years ago. But unfortunately, nothing has been implemented. We request our party government to put in place stricter measures to control wildfires. This will mitigate the effect of drought, which is most severe since modern records in Namibia. The control of wildfires will enable to save the grass for animals and thereby save government money to buy fodder.
1 minute.
In conclusion, we salute our Swakopmund government for its caring attitude towards the Namibian people. I thank you.
Thank you very much. We now have the Maye Traditional Authority. I hope I'm protected while directing the ceremony and I will not have charges from our TA when I leave here.
Thank you very much, Director of Ceremony. I would like to thank the President to bring the whole Parliament here. Thank you very much for that. Since most of our points have been covered by our colleagues, I think reputation couldn't do better. So I've got only one point whereby, as if we can recall back, the colonial government forced all our communities from the national parks, where the national parks are today, to where they are today. But one funny part of it is only the government benefiting from that. Not even a single benefit, not even a farthing. Please, could you kindly do something about this problem of world conflict with humans? Animals are killing people, especially elephants. Right now, we are just mourning one of our sons has been killed by an elephant. Please, 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 do something for that. In that matter, this is all I had because some of my points have been covered by
Excellent. I think our traditional authorities have set the pace. Can we adhere? If I can stop the traditional authorities, I don't know what I will do to the rest. So can we really cooperate and adhere to time? Let's not make the speeches, pick up the main points and questions from your submissions. Only pick the questions, do not make long statements. Can I have Mr. Munyaza for the War Veterans of Namibia Association in Zambezi? Mr. Munyaza? Mr. Munyaza will be followed by the launch operators, Mr. Simon, can you be nearer?
Thank you so much. Zambezi region. All protocol observed. His Excellency, we have got 10 points, but I know I'm going to cover them. The first sentiment and the problem that we want to raise is members, the veterans are concerned of a long delays in the veterans project approval, as many of the veterans have passed on their projects still in process and has caused frustrations and psychological stigma in some members. That's the first one. Secondly, on veteran houses, this project seems not to work well in Zambezi region. The houses that are approved and built in this region seem to take a very little test in the Zambezi region. So it is plus minus almost 5 houses are realized in the 8 constituencies. The other point, it is veterans are concerned of the grant that they are given, that of 2,200. As you are aware of high inflation and unbearable cost of living and the current financial constraint prevailing countrywide and worldwide. His Excellency, if you can kindly mediate with the Minister of Veteran Affairs, we came up with a proposal that if this grant be raised to 3,700 as a moral obligation of the government to effect the pressing inequality in the veterans. The other one is His Excellency, as you are aware, the Act, Veterans Act, even though it does not provide or it provides the provision of the deceased veterans' graves to be saved with tombstones. But we have got a serious concern here. There are a lot of delays after the deceased and the burial services has taken place for us to give us opportunity to at least have that opportunity to provide proper service to our colleagues. The other one, it is families of the deceased comrades, especially in exile and inside the country, are dismayed of the initiative that was taken to register them for consideration. But this exercise, His Excellency, it is also affecting the families of the two sides, both of those who have perished in exile and those also inside. The other one, it is on the education grant for struggling children and the main members. We have observed that this seems not to be efficiently serve the purpose, as members have not benefited anything so far. The other one, it is about the shrines. The Act also provides that in every region there must be a place where
veterans must be rested in peace. These people must be at least be given opportunity to at least be given that dignified position by their comrades. So we want your office through the Minister of Veteran Affairs as well as the Regional Council to intervene to see to it that we rest our comrades in a very dignified manner. Even though this other one has mentioned for Kamenga, it is true we are dismayed, His Excellency, because you have been in Zambia, you have been heading an institution. You know that Kamenga is a liberation battle front in Kobola constituency. It was a war zone during 1974 to 1980 before the withdrawal of the combatants to go in the northern front. But the history of that area should be preserved. We are asking this question.
The conclusion, please.
Yes.
Yes, I like the points.
Yes. The last one, it is His Excellency, the association receives 1 million rand to at least serve the purpose and the factions in the region. So we felt that this 1 million is no more enough for 14 regions currently, as we have got a very, very big budget. So you'll find that a region may be receiving from that 1 million either 5,000 or 6,000. That is not sufficient to cover the needs and the moral obligation.